Welcome to the Ruth Institute podcast for October 3rd, 2024. Today, Father Rob Jack and Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse talk about the recent abuse allegations against rapper P Diddy and how this relates to Jeffrey Epstein and other entitled rich, powerful people.
Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse is the head of the Ruth Institute, an interfaith nonprofit organization helping defend the family and repair the dangers of the damage of the sexual revolution. Thank you for being with us today, Dr. Morse.
Well, thanks for having me, Father.
You know, one of the things, and it's clear, there's always, for people who are living their everyday lives, there is, we think about just things in ordinary terms, but there's another level of life or a hidden world that oftentimes is lived by the ultra celebrity or the ultra rich. And when that becomes known to us, it becomes actually quite sickening, I believe.
Well, are you talking about the P. Diddy revelations that he's being sued by multiple women for abusing them and
You have musicians that come in and are young and they end up committing suicide afterwards because of the business and the connections and the drug. You know, a young British woman, Amy Winehouse, was a wonderful singer and got into the whole drug culture of the uber rich and all the status and celebrity. And in the process, it's like selling your soul to the devil.
Exactly. It looks like a good deal. Or when the person is really young in the first place and their judgment is perhaps not all that great, you know. Immaturity is rampant among the young. That's what I heard. And so, therefore, it can be easy to seduce somebody into doing something which against their better judgment. And it happens all the time. And the problem with the sexual revolution, you know, there's the drug side of it, and then there's the sex side of it, right? And the two go hand in glove very often for a number of reasons. But one of the reasons is that the self-indulgence is self-indulgence, you know, and if you think you're entitled to indulge yourself in drugs and alcohol, you're reducing your inhibitions, and now the whole sexual self-indulgence comes into play,
living down in the South, as you are, Dr. Morse, you know, it's more than just the person doing this. Oftentimes, there are handlers. You know, they want to how do we control this person? We control them by taking away their free will. And how do we do that? Well, we groom them in this or in that or the other thing, or we get them going with these different groups. And all of it, and you see this happening a lot. But when you get especially the extra evil types of the P. Diddy Combs or the Jeffrey Epsteins or the Harvey Weinsteins, you know, they go to a much deeper, more perverted level as a type of some kind of it's just plain hedonism.
Well, and they think they're entitled, you know, and this is the contribution of the sexual revolution's ideology to the whole problem. I mean, people have wanted to indulge themselves and pick on weak people. That's part of human nature. That's been around forever and ever. But what we've developed over the past 50 years is a whole culture that endorses it. You know, basically says sexual activity is an entitlement, and the only barrier is consent. Well, we should by now have figured out that consent can be manipulated and manufactured. You know, and so that's a very, very weak reed on which to hang things. And so now the net result, I think, taking this point and a bunch of other things that have been going on, we've got a global ruling class that literally has no moral compass at all. You know, they're literally out for themselves to do whatever they think they can get away with. And we see this in many, many sectors of society. You know, I don't want to bloviate and get too exaggerated here, but, you know, that the reports that come out are just kind of one field after another where you're seeing this type of stuff.
Well, and again, the whole it's another type of evil grooms. Evil, you know, we try to groom people in goodness. We call that virtue. But there's also grooming of people in evil, and we call that vice. And when vice has no accountability, because you talk about these people, I mean, there's still the question when all the Epstein stuff came out, you know, the little black book would have names of people, I'm sure, very prominent. And so you see, you know, Puff Diddy Combs or these others, they're the tip of the iceberg. They're the minor leaguers. You know, they're not the major leaguers who are bringing these kids in through the drug cartels and all of that. And I'm not, you know, people think you're being, you know, overdramatic. Right. No, all you have to do is read their stories.
Well, and not only that, but if you just ask yourself, Jeffrey Epstein had this whole list of clients. Have we seen any? Where are the other indictments? You know, who else was guilty? You know, he killed himself. Did you know he killed himself?
Well, that was the rumor.
No serious person thinks he killed himself, right? And so they got his accomplice. I forget her name escapes me at the moment.
But, oh, Giselle, you know, something or other. Yeah,
that's the person I'm thinking of. But look at here. Queen Elizabeth believed that Prince Andrew was guilty. Okay, she treated him like he was guilty.
Right.
So, you know, and then you're telling me there's not a single other person on that whole list of clients that Jeffrey Epstein supposedly had. Not a single one of them has been brought to justice. You know, come on, people. If you're going to, don't yell at me about being a conspiracy theorist. Be transparent, and then we don't have to theorize like this, you know? If people would release the truth and face up to the truth and prosecute people who should be prosecuted, we wouldn't have to be speculating. But the fact is, we've got a trail of inferences that we can draw that points back to people. Goodness knows how high it reaches, but it's obvious that somebody with a lot of power and a lot of influence allowed Jeffrey Epstein to be killed in his cell. You know, I mean, who gets into a federal prison and allows this to happen? You know, who turns their back? Who makes it happen? You know, these are people with extremely high reach, and every honest person realizes that this must be going on. And so therefore, you ask yourself, you know, the questions that the lady from Heritage was raising. All these kids have disappeared. We can't keep track of them. And yet the open border policy continues. Gosh. You know, are we not allowed to put two and two together and wonder where those kids are? What's happened to those kids? You know,
no, because we're not in the wealthy class. Again, these people right. do it with impunity, and oftentimes when someone like, you know, P. Diddy gets caught, it's only because someone higher up was getting close to getting caught, so they throw a bone. You know, they throw one of the low-hanging fruits off so that way, you know, the higher-ups can still be protected because, you know, the same is said about the rap industry and much of that stuff that goes on.
Right.
And, again, this is the situation of many of these rap moguls and these worth millions of dollars and doing these terrible parties and inviting young people to come in and grooming and, you know, turning up, you know, all the celebrity and the power and the desire for that. It's a sad thing, Dr. Morse.
Well, sure, it sure is. You know, I mean, I don't. How can I disagree with that? You know.
Well, I'll tell you, I wish we would have had more time today, but we are having. Someone probably didn't want us to have this conversation. That's me talking. But anyway, if people want to read the article that you wrote on this, as well as get more information from the Ruth Institute, where can we send them?
Come on over to ruthinstitute.org, and that's where you'll find the press release that we issued with my statement about P. Diddy. And then also over at our YouTube channel, we have resurrected a talk that I gave in 2020 about how the global ruling class actually likes pedophilia just
yes.
fine.
That's...
People will like that video, too.
Well, thanks for being with us, Dr. Morse. You have a wonderful day.
Thanks for having me, Father.